Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And greetings to all panel, Madam Nolina and Madam Nolida. Our final project is upper bound of second hand kindergarten for certain generalized class of starlight function. And we are supervised by Encik Abdullah bin Yahya, and thanks for him for guiding us. My team members are Muhammad Hakim bin Shahruddin as our group leader, and me, Muhammad Azawi Dahan bin Badu Isham, and third member is Madison Joanne Manuel. Geometric function theory is an old subject of mathematics which has become one of the most outstanding branches of complex analysis. This research focuses on the geometric properties of analytic function. In the history of geometric function, 97, the theory of regular function, or well known as regular function, was first studied by Kobe, Arora and Sharma in 2015. For 1914, Grover studied and proved the area theorem of Arora and Sharma in 2015. In 1916, Weber estimated in 1916 the second coefficient of C of unit value function under normalized condition. He proved in form of Taylor series expansion. While in 1984, Louis Debranche finally settled down the Weber-Bach conjugation, or the most famous coefficient problem, Debranche, in 1985. Since Louis Debranche solved the conjugation, many mathematicians inspired by him to further the study on coefficient inequalities. One of the earliest discoveries on coefficient inequalities is the Piketty-Zeego problem. For A equals to 1, there will be a Hankel determinant problem that we will further discuss later. Next, Hankel determinant. Krishna and Venkateswarlu and Murray Reddy in 2015 consider A that deduct the class of analytic function fz of the form of this equation. Erebor in 2000 found that the Hankel determinant of order n plus 1 is the determinant of corresponding Hankel matrix. Thomas and Noonan in 1976 defined that Q Hankel determinant of F for Q is greater than 1 by substitute Q equals to 2 and M equals to 2, also by applying triangle inequality, we will receive this matrix. Next is problem statement. In previous research, there are many definitions and theorems on generalized subclasses of analytic function, such as class of function with positive real part, class of convex function, class of star-like function, and class of close to convex function. There are two objectives in this project. First, to discover and define a new generalized subclass of analytic function. Second, to determine the upper bound for Hankel determinant for the class of star-like function. Next is significance and benefit of study. The new generalized subclass in the research are now yet to be found by any researcher and give a new result of Hankel determinant for a new class of function. This research also improves the result obtained in the previous research paper. The result obtained for the research may be significant to other researchers to further their research or study of coefficient inequalities in geometric function theory. Scope and limitation of study. The research concentrated on the class of unit value function. It only limited to the finding of upper bound known as Hankel determinant. As the method used in this study involve unfamiliar long division and complex number, the calculation implemented in this study are extracted from previous research paper, but the result obtained is different. Next is literature review. First, Jantin, Halim and Darus in 2006 obtained a sharp upper bound of subclasses for analytic function. Next, Kaharuddin, Akrabali, Muhammad and So in 2011 obtained the result on sharp upper bound of Hankel determinant for this function for the close to convex function. Next, Yahya Su and Muhammad in 2013 attained the sharp upper bound for second hand determinant for a class of generalized Sakaguchi class or analytic function. For Bansal in 2013 obtained a result of this equation where the upper bound is sharp. Krishna and Murray in 2015 obtained the sharp upper bound second hand determinant for the function of belong to Moicano class, and the result obtained coincide with the result obtained by Jantin et al. In 2007. Next, we go for the second presenter.
Hi, I'm Maxan Joy Manuel. So next we move on to methodology. First one is to use lemma that proven by Pomerenke, Stoiber's determinant, and Libra and Zlotkiewicz. Next one is to determine the value of A2, A3, and A4, so that we can solve for inequalities of the modulus A2, A4 minus A3 squared. And then we find the value of FPn, F'Pn, GP, and G'P. Next we evaluate for FPV, F'Pv, JP, and J'P. And lastly we obtain the upper bound and final result of A. Next is the result and discussion. In this research, the new class of function T, alpha, delta, beta in the unit dis is defined as the class of star-like functions. Functions in this class are normalized functions given by the following equations. This is the theorem 4.2.1. The following equations are achieved. And then we simplify the equations. Afterwards, we multiplying the both sides with 1 over cos alpha minus delta to obtain these equations. And then we relate the functions of T to the functions in P so that F be the element of T if and only if the pz be the element of P. Conversely, from 3.2.1, taking pz equals to 1 plus summation of cn z power of n, apply the bottom-up calculations to verify that condition 3.2.1 is satisfied. The second one is the lemma 4.2.2. And here's the proof of the lemma. By using Taylor series formula, the given function is hz is equals to z over 1 minus beta z squared. And then we differentiate it 7 times. Afterwards, we substituting value of z equals to 0 to obtain these equations. And lastly, we substitute the value into the formula of Taylor series and achieve the long equations. Hence, the lemma 4.2.2 was proven. Next is the main result. The first one is theorem 4.3.1. Here's the proof. From the previous subtopic, we can obtain the equations 4.3.1.1. And in the meantime, fz can be equal to z plus summation of cn z power of n. And then we differentiate it with respect to z to achieve the equation 4.3.1.2. The small p be the element of p so that pz can be written in the form of 1 plus summation of pn z power of n. The following equations are based on the theorem 4.3.1. We substitute the pz and hz from the equation 4.3.1.1 and then elaborating and rearranging it to obtain 4.3.1.4. By substitute a and exponent negative I alpha into 4.3.1.4, we obtain 4.3.1.6 by rearranging the equation. Equating the coefficients of z, z squared, and z cubed on both sides of equations yields 2a2, 3a3, and 4a4. And finally, from the lemma 1, the value of the modulus a2 and a3 can be obtained. The next one is theorem 4.3.2. Equating the coefficient of z cubed yields 4a4. Thus, the value of a4 can be achieved from a2 and a3. The value of a2, a4, and a3 squared can be obtained by multiplying 4.3.2.1 and 4.3.2.2. Therefore, we can solve for a2, a4 minus a3 squared. Introducing absolute value and assuming the exponent negative I alpha equals to 1, we obtain 4.3.2.5. The bound obtained is the modulus p to beta. By using the lemma 3 and application of the triangle inequality, we obtain the equation 4.3.2.6. Since the differentiation is greater than 0, f is increasing and maximum f is equals to f p 1 beta, then g p beta is equals to 2 beta. Hence, the bound gives less than or equals to beta, which implies the equation 4.2.3.8. Next, applying the same method to find the second bound, which is using an application of the triangle inequality and simplifying the equations to obtain the equation 4.3.2.9. Further differentiation process will obtain the value of j p beta. Therefore, the respective upper bounds can be solved, which implies the equations 4.3.2.11. Substitutes these three equations to obtain the modulus of a2 a4 minus a3 squared. And based on Janteng 2007, the equation can be finalized. After using quadratic formula, the equation is simplified to obtain the final result. Hence, this completed the proof of theorem 4.3.2.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Akim Syarudin, and now I will proceed into the validation of result. From theorem 4.3.2, the result of upper bound of second Hankel determinant can be reduced into few corollary and remarks. So for first corollary 4.4.1, if beta is equal to 1, the class will be reduced into result obtained by Yahya et al. 2013. Therefore, the upper bound obtained is 1 over 9 plus 4 over 9 a alpha delta plus 5 over 9 a alpha delta squared. And a alpha delta is less than or equal to 0.9266. However, the result obtained is different from Yahya et al. 2013, where they obtained 1 over 9 plus 4 over 9 a alpha delta plus 19 over 36 a alpha delta squared, where a alpha delta is less than or equal to 0.9433. After reviewing the result, we found that the maximum value of p for 9p1 squared beta plus 9p1p3 minus 8p2 squared is different from our study. For remark 4.4.2, if beta is equal to negative 1, then the result is 1 over 9 plus 4 over 9 a alpha delta plus 65 over 36 a alpha delta squared, where a alpha delta is less than or equal to 0.8354. Remark 4.4.3, if beta is equal to 1 over 2, then the result is 1 over 36 plus 2 over 9 a alpha delta plus 257 over 57 still a alpha delta squared, where a alpha delta is less than or equal to 1.2480. Next, remark 4.4.4, if beta is equal to negative 1 over 2, then the result is 1 over 36 minus 2 over 9 a alpha delta plus 617 over 576 a alpha delta squared, where a alpha delta is less than or equal to 1.0620. Remark 4.4.5, if beta is equal to 1 over 4, then the result is 1 over 144 plus 1 over 9 a alpha delta plus 1145 over 2304 a alpha delta squared, where a alpha delta is less than or equal to 1.3062. Remark 4.4.6, if beta is equal to negative 1 over 4, then the result is 1 over 144 minus 1 over 9 a alpha delta plus 1865 over 2304 a alpha delta squared, where a alpha delta is less than or equal to 1.0411. For the last remark, if beta equal to 0, the result is 89 over 144 a alpha delta squared, where a alpha delta is less than or equal to 1.2720. Hence, it proven that the upper bound of second Hankel determinant k a alpha delta squared can be reduced into various type of class of function. Finally, conclusion and recommendation. As a conclusion, this project managed to achieve the first objective, which is to establish the new generalized subclass of analytic functions t a alpha delta beta with the lemma stated before, and second objective, which is to find the upper bound of second Hankel determinant for the class of starlet function. For the recommendation, we recommend that other researchers to further the study on several features such as region of starlightness and area of convexivity using the appropriate numerical technique. Hence, the researcher results can be coincided by the results obtained from this paper. And that's all from group P2M21. Thank you.